In this video, I'm going to show you how to easily update any plugin or theme without having to delete the existing installed version first. I know that's a mouthful. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress videos for non-techies. If you find the content in this video valuable to you, I'd like to encourage you to click on that subscribe button. And if you want notifications, click on the bell just off to the right of the subscribe button. You know, this is something that really should be in the core of WordPress, in my opinion. And I've always hated this. So there's a lot of situations where you have a plugin or theme on your WordPress website, but you don't have a way of automatically updating it. So a perfect example is anything you might get from or purchase from Code Canyon or Theme Forest. You have to go through a bunch of extra hoops in order to have automatic updates, which you actually should do anyway. But there's also other scenarios too, where you might have a plugin that you want to downgrade, but in order to do that, you have to deactivate and delete it first, because if you try to do that update, WordPress will say the folder already exists. Let me show you what I am talking about. So here is the name of the plugin. I'm going to I've already installed it. Go to plugins, add new, and then do a search for it. Here it is, Easy Theme and Plugin Upgrades. And what this plugin's going to do is it's going to allow you to install a new theme or plugin like you normally would, and if it's an update, it will just overwrite what's already there. So here is actually a perfect example. Is one of my favorite page builders. It's called Elementor. And if you're not familiar, I have a ton of content on Elementor. In fact, I even made a video where I compared Elementor to Beaver Builder. And my biggest criticism of Elementor was sometimes they push out updates that are problematic, and they can cause these problems and you will regret having updated. Well, let me show you everything I'm talking about. So I'm going to go to my plugins. You can see I have Elementor installed right here, and I have version 1.4.7. So say I just upgraded and it's causing problems and I need to go back a version. Well, if you have a local copy, you can do that, or you could go to WordPress.org, their page right here. And right now you could click on Advanced View. They keep tweaking this layout and it might change. But if you go to Advanced View and then you scroll down, here's an option that says Previous Version. So I'm going to go ahead and download the previous version, this 1.4.6. I'm going to go ahead and click on download. Okay, now that that's downloaded, this is what you would normally do. Actually, here, let me go ahead and deactivate my Easy Theme plugin and upgrades. So in order to downgrade Elementor, I would have to deactivate it and then delete it. Now that is a scary thing, because I cannot be 100% sure every plugin or theme author has coded their plugin or theme properly, and you're not going to lose some of your settings. A good plugin or theme author is going to give you the option of having it be your info still be there when you reinstall the updated or the prior version. And even better plugin authors and theme authors will give you an option to have it delete the data if you wanted. Anyways, so this is what would normally happen. You would go to Add New, and then you would click Upload Plugin, and then you would drag and drop your plugin right there from your local computer. You click on Install Now. It's going to upload it to the site, and it's going to give you this plugin install failed, and it's going to say because the destination folder already exists. Now let's go ahead and activate that plugin, the Easy Theme and Plugin Upgrades. I'm going to click on activate, and we're going to try it over again. So I'm on Elementor 1.4.7. I'm going to click Add New, and then I'm going to click on Upload Plugin and do the same thing, but this time I'm going to click on Install Now, and let's see what happens. So look at the difference. It says right here that it's upgrading the plugin. So it realized with this new plugin that I added, it realized that I'm trying to upgrade or just have a different version. It doesn't know if I'm downgrading or upgrading. It just knows it's already installed and I want to put a different version of the same plugin in my website. And then look what it does. It backs up the old version, and it actually puts it in the media library so you can easily download it if you wanted to. And it says right here, it even gives you a link to download the version that you just replaced. And then it updated the plugin successfully. I'm going to go ahead and click on Activate Plugin. And then we're going to go to Plugins and see what version it is. You can see now I'm on 1.4.6, what I just wanted to add. Now, this I think is huge and it should be in the core of WordPress. I do not know why it isn't, but this is going to make things a lot easier for a lot of people. Now, obviously, if you're a developer or someone that's more technical, you can FTP in and then just copy and overwrite files. And that's actually what I usually do. And the reason I do that is because I can't do it this way. But now with this plugin, I can do it this way. And I think for the people that have a website because they need one and they're trying to manage it themselves, this will make things so much easier, especially when it comes to themes. You will say you only have one theme on your website. You don't have a temporary one to switch to while you delete this one and then you upload and update. It's very wonky the way that WordPress does it, in my opinion. It should do it this way by default. But it's nice that with this plugin that is completely free, and if you go to their WordPress.org page, you'll see it's installed on well over 100,000 websites, and it has fantastic reviews, so it's going to be a reliable plugin for you. And I just think this is just a fantastic solution. Let me just jump into the media library, and yep, there it is. Here it is, the Elementor that it was there. It actually put both in here, which is actually really nice, because then now I actually have a copy locally on my WordPress website that I can download and revert to very easy. Would be real nice if I could click on this and then click a button to switch to it, but you know, I'm happy with this functionality as it is. So anyways, guys, this is a super easy way for you to update your plugins and themes, and I totally recommend staying on top of your plugins and themes, or even downgrading to a prior version if you've upgraded and you're having problems.